Hey guys, so today we have this Ram in the shop, and when you see this on early 2000 Rams, you have to do an amp bypass if you're changing out the head unit, because it's, you pretty much just can't turn on the factory amplifier. Now, if someone's gone ahead and done some work, we have to repair all this, but the reason why I'm making this video is because I saw these. I'm sorry, imaging from the back of your head, like literally off the back of your head, is not awesome. These are mounted improperly. I don't know, I guess someone just decided, like, let's put speakers up here. Like, yeah, image off here. Put it off here. It's going to bounce off the windshield, come at you. That's way better than bouncing off the back of your head. I'm just sorry. It sounds weird and it's just wrong. So if you're going to do any kind of audio system that's loud, do everything else but this. Here is a 2010 Nissan Frontier. You can see they have drivers in the door and they have dash speakers up top, so they fire up into the windshield. We're now in a G37 sedan. You can see that driver down low, tweeter up here, and also the center channel in the middle as well. Now we're in a BMW 530i. You can see the tweeter again in front of you on near the pillar. We're near the A pillar. These are also called like sail panels if you want, because they kind of look like a sail. We're now in a newer BMW 328i. See for speaker placement, speaker up top, tweeter up top near the mirror. Then our mid-range or smaller speaker mid-range for frequency down low right in front of the listener. It also has a center channel placement as well in the dash. Here's an early 2000 GM truck. You can see here the tweeter is located up here with the mid-range driver down low, again in front of the listener. We're in my 2006 Nissan 350Z, and this is where the factory location is for the tweeters. Now you can see that I've drilled holes and I've exposed the whole tweeter because there's only little tiny holes in them, and I figure I'd be reducing the performance of the tweeter quite a bit by not exposing the whole thing. Now, a lot of people think because it is technically angled down a bit that you don't get good imaging. Well, given how close you are to these tweeters and it's a dome, it's not completely flat because high frequencies are extremely directional depending where you point it. It does image nicely in here. Like, you have to really sit in this car and listen to it to actually appreciate how good it sounds for not having to angle them straight at you. Because sometimes I find on some cars when they put these really big tweeters and they're facing right at you on the A-pillars, it does look great, but it's like really in your face. It's cool though, like I love listening to it. It's just I don't know if I would want to be listening to that all the time, but you know, to each their own. This is my 2005 Chevy Silverado. On a lot of the GM trucks in the early 2000s, some of the premium models did place the tweeter here, or if they have power windows, there's a tweeter here with a mid-range woofer like I showed you in that other GM truck. I like coming off of here. Actually, it's not for everyone because it does bounce off the windshield, but what I like is it kind of sounds like all the music's coming off of here. Some people like to actually aim the tweeter directly at them in the front, and that's cool too. I find it's too in your face for me. But that's why we always discuss with the customer, how do you want it to sound? You know, this is what I recommend. Here's my vehicle. What do you think? And you know, everyone has their own style. But again, having your music come from the front. The main reason why I don't like it coming off like where that Ram was coming at the back of your head. If you think about how your ears are designed, like look in the mirror and you'll see that your ears are designed to take music coming at you. The back of your ears won't receive music that well, and really this placement, having sound, like if this is your head, having sound come down this way, well basically you're mimicking the imaging of having your mom nag at you. That's what this is. This is like your mom, your teacher, your wife nagging at the back of your head, and you won't have anything to do with it. Now, why would you associate your music with that? Have your music come from the front like you're at a concert. You don't go to a concert, walk up to the front stage, and turn your head to them, so why do that in your car? To see what else I'm up to, check out my Facebook and Instagram, AnthonyJ350, and also check out our website, www.gofasthavefun.ca.